All right, I'm gonna make this this book match top that I cut out of this one board. I'm gonna make it work from the top of my component cabinet that I'm making for myself. Now I wouldn't be able to get away with this for one of my clients. They wouldn't like something that had such a big repair in the top. But for me, it's okay. I can't justify spending the money on perfect wood like I would for one of my clients, and this is going to be great for me. I'm very frugal, and so I like making a silk purse out of a sow's ear. So what I'm going to use for my repairs is normally I use 5-minute epoxy. You've probably seen it, but I bought this, the 2-ton. This is a much slower set, so this is going to give me a lot more time to do my repair. I'm not going to have to race so much because the repairs are going to be big. And over the years, I know that if I buy this briarwood oil-based putty, this is a really good color for this mahogany. So by the time the finish goes on at the waterlock, so I'll do all my repairs first, sand them flat, and but I mix this with the epoxy and create a colored penetrator, and then sand it flat, and it's a pretty good look. You put, you know, 6 coats of finish on top of it, and it's not the first place your eye goes to. So I'm going to make this work, and I'm going to be really happy with it. It's still beautiful wood. Just because it has a few defects in it doesn't mean that it's, you know, garbage. So you see, I made my repairs here. I think that the other side, you know, this one was the one that was actually weakened because the fracture was so deep through it. I don't know where this came from. This may have been like a wind shake from when this tree was younger and was maybe in a big storm that fractured that thing in there, and it never really, you know, like a scar in a tree and never really grew back. But regardless, we're going to make it work. But I think this is the side that is going to be the upside, and then this one too. So I think it's these guys are, I think it's going to be like this. But I've got this book matched, and you know, so the repairs aren't that bad. I'm going to repair the bottom too, because I'm going to drive, you know, I already glued this with Type Bond 3, but I'm going to drive that epoxy far down into here to finish off my repair too. So it should be good and solid. So let me get these boards planed, and while the other panels are setting up, you can see that the one I've still got in the clamps back there, it's been in for about 3 hours, and it's going to be ready. By the time I get ready to you know, get this planed down, the edges joined, kind of cleaned up a little bit, it'll be ready to take those clamps off, and then I'll pass those two guys through the planer and then get them clamped up also. I have enough clamps for that. And you can see here, so this pile of wood right here, these are just sticks I kind of collected from around my shop, and while I'm doing some joinery, running some stuff over my joiner, I'll just go ahead and flatten a face of all of these. It only has to be one face. So these are going to be my clamping calls that I'll put on here and put a clamp here and here, you know, one on both sides, paper in the middle to make sure it's not going to stick. And then this is going to make sure that I draw my panel flat. I just learned a long time ago that if you just do the extra effort of putting calls on, especially when you're working alone, and I mean, if you had a big clamping platform, you know, one of these fancy clamping things, you know, I don't do it enough. You know, I mean, I clamp panels a lot, but I'm not a cabinet shop, so I don't do it that much. But this is a low-tech way to just really ensure that you're drawing your panels up, you know, absolutely flat. So that just takes away so much of the later work of scraping and you know, sanding and stuff. So if your panel starts out flat and then you come in with your half-sheet sander, you're almost done. I mean, it's a great look. Okay, so let me get these guys run through the planer. I don't think you need to see this. It's just going to be some boring planer work. No one needs that. Okay, so if you remember, our board was like this, and we resawed our board and laid it open. And so I've chosen what I think is going to be the best top, and I think you'll agree. So this is what the top is going to look like. It's going to be this bookmatch piece like this. And you know, I do have these fracture marks in here, but this is not that bad. I can make this look fantastic. You know, I mean, like I said, I'm going to use my slower set epoxy mixed with a colored putty, and I'm just going to fill all this in and then sand it flat, and it'll look good. Yes, I'm definitely going to change my mind. See, a lot of times you just don't know until you actually lay things out. You know, so here, you know, here's our drawing, and I know that 16 is what I was hoping to net here. I don't think I'm going to be able to be quite at 16. I'm at 15 and 7/8, and by the time I join this and trim that, I'll be a little bit less. I'll probably end up being about 15 and 3/4. But my side edges, I wanted 10, so that's quite a sweeping arc. And I may change that too. I mean, that may be too much. I may look at this after I lay it out. And so see if I'm... So here's 10, so I'm gonna cut that crack completely away. So I'm gonna have it this way. I think actually this is a better look with the ribbon stripe coming together more like this too. And this bad thing will be on more on the back. So I'm saying this is gonna be the front. So I'm getting ready to pass these through the planer so I can clean this up. And but I only have to clean one side of this because the planer will cut the other stuff off the other side. The glue is still soft enough, like I said, that it's not going to damage my planer blades. But you know, this is why I just prefer to do this than a bunch of crazy water everywhere and smear the glue. You know, and just this much time. That's done. That's ready to go. That's clean enough. Absolutely flat. I can just feel how flat they are, just laying it on top of one another. So now I'm going to lay these guys out and join them and have my two top and bottom panels here in a little while. All right, here's the top glued up, and I've got all my cauls and clamps on it. And I really don't know of a better way to do this kind of panel clamping. you know, I'm sure there are complicated panels gluing setups, but for a small shop that, you know, these clamps can be used for many, many other things besides just this. But when you take your scrap wood, your cauls, flatten it, then pinch everything down, and you know, you did a nice dry fit on your joint, I'm telling you, it's going to be a perfect joint. And I don't see any, this is a Mitutoyo, and I don't see any air underneath this. The glue right there, wow. So it's just a great way, it's a simple low-tech way to glue panels. And, you know, like I said before, that if you know, you had a big panel, it would be kind of hard to do this like this. So you may need to straddle it across some sawhorses or what have you, but you really need the access to get your cauls on it. That's why I like doing it like this. And see, I've got it clamped to this table, so it can't get off and fall and make a mess. And the other side is clamped over to my vacuum station. But again, since everything is all at the exact same height, it's clamped over there. You know, so it's just a real simple, low-tech way to work, you know, without a huge investment. So the main thing is just to have the clamps. If you have the clamps, then you can create the flexibility that you need to just do anything. But you know, I've got six of these, and I've got six of this size, and I've got six of this size, and I've had these for 25 years. And those are real Jorgensens, you know, they're not some Chinese knockoffs. And then the pipe clamps, of course, are just your most versatile friend. But it's all about having the clamps and then just creating a setup. So here's my second panel glued up with cauls. So now I'm gonna take the clamps off, straighten up a little bit, get all my clamps out of my way, scrape the glue off, and then the next thing I'm gonna do is create a straight edge on one edge and then work on my arcs. All right, that's all there is to it to get the glue off. So let me flip the other side over and do it.